Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, in the name of God, the most merciful and the most compassionate. Have you ever seen a Muslim and assumed that they were a terrorist or that Islam teaches violence? Well, today I would like to share with you some things that Islam does teach. People often think that Islam is a religion of violence. However, this is not true. The word Islam comes from a word meaning peace and translates to submission to God in English. The Holy Quran teaches patience and God consciousness in everything we do. In fact, if you read the Holy Quran, chapter 5, page 57, verse 32, it says, "We have ordained for the children of Israel that if you kill one innocent person, it is as if you've killed the whole world. And if you save one innocent person, it is as if you've saved all of mankind." Also, the greeting we use every day, "Assalamu alaikum," means, "May peace be upon you." Of course, not everyone follows their religion the way they should. There are people from all different religions who use religion to justify their own actions. That does not mean that the entire population of followers feels the same way they do. ISIS is a group that is in no way related to the teachings of Islam. ISIS is not following Islam because they are killing innocent people, including Muslims. Muslims condemn terrorism, no matter who is committing it. In 2015, there were over 350 mass shootings, but only 3 of them were committed by people claiming to be Muslim. However, anyone who believes in God knows that it is wrong to kill innocent people. Terrorism has no religion. People often assume that all Muslims are Arab, but actually, out of the 1.9 million Muslims in the world, only 20% of them are Arab. Our holy book was revealed to the world in Arabic, and that is why our prayers are said in Arabic. Being a Muslim these days isn't always easy. I've personally been bullied, threatened to be bombed, threatened to be shot by a machine gun, and told that I should go back to my country, which is odd considering that I was born right here in St. Augustine. Muslim and has experienced racism in public just because she wears a scarf like other religious people. The truth is that Islam, Christianity, and Judaism aren't as different as we all think. Yes, there are some differences, but there are also many similarities. Instead of arguing over religions, I think that we should just try to respect each other's. I hope the next time you see a Muslim person, you'll know not to judge them for what some people do. I will respect your religion. Will you respect mine? My name is Ibrahim Zori, and I'm a Muslim, not a terrorist.